excited about presenting the music of Stevie Wonder. It's so full of many emotions. I think all these emotions we've been experiencing all year, you will definitely feel in the music. And my band here with me, you're gonna meet, and they are just pure magic.
Close your eyes till the morning. Thank you. Hi, my name is Peter, and I can't tell you, and I'm wondering if the rest of the band feels like, I have not done a gig in a year, and to hear the applause is really, Rebecca, what is that, man?
Thank you.
Songs in the Key of Life, Stevie Wonder. For so many of us, his music has meant so much. For us jazz musicians, there's this incredible blend of harmony. Like, you think of some very great rock songs or pop songs, and there's four chords. And Stevie Wonder, man, he has half-diminished chords, chords with triads over other bass notes. He's got beautiful harmony and of course, great melodies, and add the great rhythm of funk and samba that he does. So it's a real joy to play his music. And that first piece was called As If You Read My Mind. I'm looking at my chart over there. It's called As If You Read My Mind. We're going to continue now with a piece. And one of the things that we like doing is, I don't know if you've ever heard that song before, but it doesn't really go like that. Like, the roots of it are there, but we kind of do a jazz, hopefully not jazz damage, but a jazz augmentation of it. And so the same thing with this next piece, Knocks Me Off My Feet. It was on his Songs in the Key of Life record. And we do sort of a jazz, old-time ballad feel to this. Knocks me off my feet.
Summer days of imaginings in my head and words from our hearts told only to the winds, felt even without being said. I don't want to bar you in my trouble. There's something about your love that makes me weak and knocks me off my feet. There's something about your love that makes me weak and knocks me off my feet. Knocks me that makes me weak and
How about a hand for Rebecca Jade on vocals? My gosh.
Thank you so much.
It's just gorgeous. Now check out this one. This one's called I Wish. And I bet you've heard this song, and maybe not like this version, but great funk kind of tune, I Wish.
Thank you.
So, you know, one of the things we're doing is we're really cross-culturing different styles. I think Bridget and Beth come from more classical, and Rebecca, R&B, up straight up the middle, and jazz. Danny's, well, let me tell you about each of the persons. This is Danny Green on the piano. Danny's super great at jazz and Brazilian, and that's one type of music that we share and love. But he plays classical too, and he reads like music like crazy. He's got perfect pitch. He's a mini genius over there. Probably the youngest guy in the band. Are you? By far. On the bass, Gunnar Biggs. Gunnar is good with the bow too, so he's got his classical chops going. Duncan Moore playing drums. From Iowa, he knows country and western and jazz.
A few other things.
Yeah. Rebecca Jade. Bridget's on violin, and her and I get to play. We have a group that we play our blend of classical and jazz, and so we have a nice connection, and I love the way you play bluegrass, too. Bridget Dolkas.
Yeah, that's a different show.
And, of course, our very own Beth on flute.
Yeah.
And she's... She's got the tone that goes for days. That's just gorgeous to hear you play, Beth. All right, so we're gonna continue now with a medley of sorts. Bridget and I are gonna do one of Stevie Wonder's ballads called If It's Magic. We're gonna do that, and that leads into his Stevie's tune called Sir Duke, which he wrote for Duke Ellington. And it's kind of a neat tune because it has some jazz roots, but it's straight up kind of almost reggae rock beat. But he talks about Duke Ellington and how great Duke Ellington and what an influence he was. And then we go into this straight up bebop tune of mine called Etude Z. And the reason that we put this tune in there is because one of the tunes that Duke made famous was Take the A Train. And when I first wrote the song, I thought, oh, I'll call it, because what it does, this my song takes the same chord progression as Take the A Train, but I put a new melody to it. And there's a name for that.
Contrafact.
Contrafact. You ever heard of that, Danny? Mm-hmm. Yeah? All right. Pretty common in jazz. You take I Got Rhythm, for instance, would be one of the songs that there's many contrafacts to that, and a lot of the jazz musicians wrote their own melody. And it might have been, you know, there might have been cause for it because they didn't have to pay royalties, too. I don't know if that played into it, but that's what I would do. No, I don't know. The song originally was called A to Z, because, like, take the A train, A to Z. And then my friend John Offercook, the pianist, misheard it and said A to Z. And I like that better. So this is a little medley of three songs in one.
Thank you.
great solos by all, huh? Like, everyone improvising. That's really great, really fun. Okay, so we're gonna slow it down and play a song that's kind of new to me. I mean, I heard it in my earlier years, but we just added it to the repertoire. It's got a long title. I Believe When I Fall in Love, It Will Be Forever. You heard it? Yeah, check this out. It's so good.
Open.
Hey, we have one more for you, and this is the funk supreme tune called Do I Do. Rebecca, you remember what record that was on?
No, I do not. He's got so many records, I do not remember which one.
I think it was Original Music Aquarium. Anyway, there was a record that he sort of had a lot of the hits on it, but then he had four new tunes, and I think this was one of them. Leonard would know.
Leonard would know.
Leonard is a musicologist of Stevie Wonder. But this is called Do I Do. This is cool. Check it out. Thank you.
for your lips. You sing us a honey sip of chocolate, dripping kisses full of love for you.
When you believe in things that you don't understand, then you
very superstitious.